dogs can make a massive difference in people's lives. No matter how bad your day is, you're going to have a good day if you have a dog. They've made my life whole.
If everyone had hearts the same as dogs, this world would be a better place.
Someone who's struggling in their life, to add a dog is huge. It's endless love. Dogs add that extra happiness into people's lives.
On Sydney's western fringe is a picturesque doggy sanctuary.
Welcome to the Animal Welfare League. My name's Jade. It's so nice to meet the both of you.
Where people come in search of a soulmate.
I'm here to get a dog.
You're in the right place.
We found you a little chihuahua mix.
Oh, you're cute.
She is a beautiful kelpie.
Wow.
It's the best feeling finding the perfect person for the dog. They're not broken, they don't need fixing, they just need love.
It's a boy! Congratulations!
Here, dedicated animal champions rescue the orphaned and abandoned.
It's not a high-paying job. It's not something that you do to build a mansion. It's something you do because you're passionate.
And work tirelessly towards making the perfect love match.
Oh, nervous!
Oh, my God. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. She's here.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
It's like a dating agency. We make the match, and then we send them off on their very first date.
Gorgeous.
Right, definitely a swipe right.
Sometimes it's a miss.
Hey!
Oh. Oh my God, aren't you playing hard to get?
You're not in love.
No, I don't like grunting.
Penny!
Ah, Penny!
Oh, off lead, guys.
But when Cupid's arrow strikes...
Oh, look at him.
It flies straight to the heart.
Hey, are we gonna love?
To know that they're going to a warm, cuddly home and have a family to sleep with tonight, that is the ultimate for us.
Are you all right, Nick?
I've just been waiting for this day for a while.
Watching someone fall in love with a dog that you believe could be somebody's dream dog, that moment is magic.
I hope that everyone can feel this emotion, and that they can experience how beautiful dogs can be and how much they can change your life.
That doesn't pull me down the street.
All right, ready, guys? Wow, this place.
Oh, g'day, guys. How
are
you
going? Hello, how are
you? Welcome to the Animal Welfare League. I'm Mark. Sorry, what was your name? Will.
This is Finn.
Hey, Finn.
And Renee.
What brings you here today?
We're getting a dog.
Finn's an only child, and I was an only child. It was a little bit lonely growing up, and I took a lot of comfort in the animals we always had in the house, and so I'd like Finn to be able to have the same.
How long have you guys been looking for a dog for?
We've been talking about it for a long time.
And we just wanted to make sure that Finn was at a good age where he could take on that responsibility with us.
Sounds good. So you
Thank
just
you.
Want to take a seat?
Yeah.
I'll get matchmakers for you Thank guys. You. Thank you.
All right. Are you excited, mate?
Mm-hmm.
I'm excited too.
How many dogs do you want?
Three.
Three dogs.
Who's cleaning up all its poo?
Just kidding, random.
Yeah, I thought so. We've always been such big animal lovers.
Oh, look at all the pictures.
And we just thought that this is a great opportunity to help a dog in need.
Hey,
how's
it going?
Good, thank you.
I'm Emily.
Hi, Hi. Emily.
My name's Juliet.
Hi, nice Juliet.
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. So, Finn, what would be your perfect dog?
A golden retriever.
A golden retriever. Very cute. What sort of personality? What would you want it to be like?
I want it to be a seagull scarer.
A seagull?
You don't like seagulls, do you?
They take your food?
You're going to have a friend to stop that from happening.
I have had food taken from seagulls. Yeah.
Yeah. It's a serious problem.
It is.
Finn, what makes you want to rescue a dog?
So they don't get put down.
Okay. Put your mind at ease, Finn. We get them all into loving homes.
I think every dog deserves a second chance. Every dog.
Do you guys have a specific dog in mind? I know he's after a golden retriever.
Something sort of mid-size is good.
They're not really fast. What it looks like, you know, we're sort of, easy.
Whereabouts do you guys live?
In a little coastal town in the Royal National Park.
So you want a dog that obviously going to like some water?
Definitely. Like, we both like surf and we go to the beach. It'd be great to have a dog that is sort of comfortable with that. It's social and we want it to be able to come with us.
Who really fits you guys the best, and we'll come back to you.
No worries, thank you.
Wonderful. All right, guys, see you soon. All right.
How'd you go?
What a cute family.
Oh my god, they are the best, hey?
Little Finn. He's got such a cute little personality, but he's a little bit timid and shy.
How old is our Finn?
He's seven. I asked him what dog he wanted. Straight away, golden retriever.
Ah, don't we all?
Yeah.
Okay, so what dogs are you thinking?
I was thinking Tessa.
Ooh, she might actually be really good, hey?
Yeah, Tessa's a good option. Tessa had a pretty rough start to life. She came in quite malnourished. You could see her ribs, you could see her spine. And although she's only 2 years old, she really came in with a litter of puppies, which is really sad because she's such a young dog herself. In the 5 weeks Tess has been at our shelter, she's come leaps and bounds. She's a much better weight and she's looking much more comfortable with people.
Her nature when she came in was so beautiful and warm and loving, and I think everyone at the shelter here sort of fall in love with her because she's really sweet. Think she'd be quite nice with a young boy.
Mm.
Do we have any other options potentially?
Well, we do have some of her pups available. Because Finn's so quiet, having a puppy, you know when they get to like that awkward gangly stage where they're still a puppy and they're very jumpy?
Yeah.
Being like a young puppy that's jumping all over him might be a bit scary.
Big question mark. With Tess, I think with her past history, we know that she hasn't had the best start. Being a mom and being quite young, she's only 2 years old, I think she deserves a nice love at home.
Yep.
Hello again.
Hello.
How'd you go?
So, we do have an option that we think is going to be really suited to you guys. She's 2 years old. Her name is Tessa. Super playful. So gentle, really just calm, that really nice nature that you guys are looking for.
Oh my god.
Perfect to be taking out socially, great with kids.
She's one of the favourites here, like she's really forgiving of humans. She's a really lovely dog.
Sounds I can't wait.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you think, Will?
You want to go?
Yeah.
Yeah, I want to go.
Let's go.
Let's go.
So we will point you in the right direction. Straight down the path, all the way across. You'll see a sign there for the meeting tent.
Thank you.
No worries.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
I want it to come up on the couch and lick my face.
I'm so excited to meet our dog.
Hi, Mama. Are you ready?
Look at this! Oh my goodness!
Look at that little pond!
Finn has ADHD, so if we had a dog in the house, it'd just be good just for him to just go and run around and get him out and burn some energy and so on. So it'd be a handy tool for that as well.
I can see a little.
We get to see if the little paws come. Heart is racing. I'm really excited.
Oh god, I really hope that they just adore her.
Oh my god, I can see some little feet.
Today, staff at the AWL are dealing with a medical surrender.
Hey, how are you going? So we've got Zoe here, the female, and we've got Buster, our male. They've supposedly eaten the bat.
The owners did find a half-eaten bat in the backyard, which they thought Zoe and Buster might have been eating. Bats can carry quite a lot of diseases. The owners were worried about the medical expenses, so that's why they ended up having to hand them over to us.
See you guys!
Hello. Hello, just Rebecca from the Animal Welfare League. I was just returning a missed call that we had from you.
I'm just inquiring about surrendering one of our dogs.
Animal Welfare League, Kemp's Creek, this is Josh.
You're wanting to surrender a dog, no worries.
So you can't take the dog to a retirement home? So animals come into our care for various reasons and various ways as well. We have a mobile vet truck who picks up dogs from regional pounds. We're taking surrendered animals.
Good boy, it's okay.
Animals who've been abused and neglected, unfortunately. And then we also do take in medical strays as well.
My husband is turning 79, I'm turning 78 this year, and we're having a bit of a struggle.
There's so many different reasons why people have to surrender an animal.
Shake?
Wow. Some do frustrate me a little bit because I think you've just put a little bit of time in, you could still look after that dog. And then there's other reasons which are generally heartbreaking.
So how are you guys feeling now? I know obviously it's very hard. It's awful. Yeah.
It's really hard when there's a beautiful, sweet animal that has to be surrendered and now has to come into a shelter environment from a home, knowing that they're going to struggle here. And if you just want to close the door on your way out, that'd be awesome. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Hey!
You know, they don't know why they're here. They don't know what they've done wrong. And I guess that's always the trickiest part and the most heartbreaking part about it all.
There you go.
Oh my god, I can see some little feet.
The Doyles are about to meet sweet but sometimes shy bull Arab cross Tessa.
Oh my god, here she is.
Hello.
Oh my god.
Come in, sweetie.
Is that Tessa?
Very cute.
Oh my god, she's so cute.
Yeah, buddy.
They look very happy.
Look at the big smile on Finn's face.
Yeah, big smiles.
This is the beautiful Tessa.
Tessa.
Hello. Hi, beautiful.
How are you? You're very cute.
Oh, even Will.
And even Will's got a big smile on his face as well.
Tessa can be a little bit shy or timid around new people.
If you just let her have a little bit of a sniff around, and if you've got food, she'll be your best friend.
Right,
she's a very, very beautiful dog, and I hope you guys love her as much as we do.
Oh my gosh, she's beautiful. Even the colouring. Look at her. Oh my gosh.
I was just going to say, maybe we just get down on the floor.
She looks very healthy.
She does, doesn't she?
Hey, beautiful girl.
You are very sweet, aren't you?
Oh my gosh, the nature is so beautiful.
She's a little bit stiff. She's a bit scared.
Sometimes you might think a dog is fine to be patted, but there are subtle signs that shows that they're quite uncomfortable or anxious.
I want to see a bit more of her tail wagging.
Yeah, I really hope that she loosens up a bit.
Things like ears pinned back, lip licking, stiffness, tail tuck, they're all things to look for.
Don't like a dog's face right next to the kid's face.
So beautiful.
Don't want Finn hugging around her neck.
Yeah.
Just because she's a bit unsure. She's not showing any bad behaviours, but just want to make sure.
When you don't know the background of the dog or they've come from cruelty or neglect, you do need to go quite slowly with that dog.
I think if we just avoid really close handling at this stage until she's used to them. She may never have been around kids, so it is something new to her.
Can you just send Emma in?
Hello! Come in. Look out.
Zoe and Buster are a little couple that got surrendered to us on medical grounds because they ate a bat.
Let's go.
The previous owners kept them in the backyard all the time, so we'll need to see how they go with other dogs.
Hi, Zoe. Who's that, Frosty?
So we do dog-to-dog tests to make sure that the dogs are going to be safe out in the community with other dogs. We took Zoe out first for Buster.
Nah, she's just fretting. She needs a friend.
We took Buster out second.
He's quite stiff. Oh, they're so bonded. He's a lot more comfortable with Zoe around.
It was quite clear that we couldn't separate the two as they were only really relaxed when they were in each other's presence.
I'm happy to pass that.
So the best home for this little duo would be someone that's happy to take two dogs on, but they definitely need to be together.
tattoo too. Stop.
Ready? I'm ready.
Newlyweds Craig and Rodney are hoping to start their own family.
Hello.
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 How are you?
Good.
We're here to find a dog.
I didn't even need to ask. I was going to be like, ooh.
No need to ask. Very excited.
If I was a dog, I would be a Labrador for sure.
I'd just be a Maltese Terrier because I'm cute.
OMG. Give yourself a rap, mate.
How long have you two been together for?
16 years.
For 16 years?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Just recently married.
Oh, finally. Congratulations.
We are yin and yang. We are completely opposites, but we absolutely work together. I'm very out there. I'm very spontaneous.
I take a while to warm up. Why are you pulling that face for? It's not a bad thing. I just take a while to warm up.
Worried the Doyle family are getting too up close and personal with Tessa, shelter manager Sam has sent in handler Emma with some tips.
Do you just want to make sure, because she gets a bit uncomfortable if her face is too close to anyone.
Right.
And she can sit.
Sit.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Good girl.
Very good. Yeah. Good girl.
So just nothing like hugging and stuff, because she might get a bit uncomfortable. Yeah.
As matchmakers, it's not just about finding the right dog for the family. It's also about finding the right family for that dog.
One of her signs of being a bit uncomfortable is she will get really close to your face.
Oh, really?
Just because she just doesn't know what to do when she feels uncomfortable.
Yeah. Oh, okay, that's good to know also then.
I mean, it's a common mistake when people hear that a dog has been through trauma or something bad. The first thing you want to do is hug and cuddle. It's okay, it's okay.
Oh, my God.
Oh, she just came up and did it again.
I know, I think she likes you.
He's doing really well with Tessa.
I was so much more feral at 7.
Oh, great doggy. Great doggy. I love you so much. You're so cute.
No, it's nice.
Because
she's comfortable to sit there.
Yeah.
Am I best friend?
That's why I looked at you.
Oh, cue the waterworks. There's just so much love. Like that whole meeting pen, just full of little love hearts floating around everywhere, little love hearts.
Look at her, she's just perfect.
She loves me.
I couldn't ask for a better home for Tessa. This is the home she needs.
Exactly right.
Hi.
Yeah. Would you guys like to take her for a walk?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes,
yeah.
Who wants to take her? You want to take her?
Mm-hmm. Do you think Tessa likes them? Bit of a concern that she's still got her tail tucked and hasn't really loosened up.
Yeah, I think she just needs more time with them.
Doing a good job, mate. Well done.
Oh, look at the little tail. Look at the tail. Her tail is actually out and it's sort of got that curve to it.
So, like, every time we go walking with her, we'll probably carry some treats. I could probably teach her how to skate.
At the Kemps Creek Animal Shelter, newlyweds Craig and Rodney are hoping to meet their perfect pooch.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Good, thank you.
I'm Taylor.
I'm Nick.
Nice to meet you.
Rodney. Craig.
Oh, you look excited.
Excited, nervous. Not sure what's going to come our way.
So why now, guys? Why now for the baby?
We had a dog and cat, and old age got the better of them, and they passed away. For you, it's just having that little... the companion. He always goes, I miss the tap, tap, tap.
Well, like, and you miss, like, when you come home and they're so excited when you come home, they do, like, little excitement wheeze.
Absolutely.
I don't get that from him now when I come home.
Oh, yeah. Change. We're all about those excitement wheeze.
Having this dog will change my life for the better tenfold. I've had a lot of health concerns, so having a dog will benefit me greatly.
I had to have a pacemaker put in for my heart. And then after I had that pacemaker, I suffered a minor heart attack with a blood clot in my heart or near my heart. So it's good for me now to be able to go out and do exercise and with the dog and go for walks.
something that's a bit too active then perhaps might not be...
I wouldn't be able to run with it or that kind of activity.
The sort of dog you're after, what sort of company you're after with the dog?
I've always kind of had a joke where I've laughed and I'm like, oh, I'd love a little dog that I could, you know, carry around in my handbag.
Nice.
But yeah, as you can probably tell, I'm quite a positive, upbeat, out there kind of personality, and I think...
Like a dog.
But I just think that...
Oh, wow.
Just ring on tight or is it coming on? I don't know.
I love him, but yeah.
So we've got the realist and the optimist.
Correct. That's right.
Absolutely. All right, guys. Well, I think we've got a lot to work with here.
Awesome. Awesome. Leave
it with us. We'll see you soon.
Thank you, guys.
Bye.
They would like something that would be people social, perhaps kids social, dog social.
Social. We all know Frosty's pretty social.
He's been here quite a while. We've had to pop him in foster because he wasn't coping too well in shelter.
And obviously the cons is that Frosty's a bit older.
Yeah.
What about Zoe and Buster?
Oh, they just come in. Yep, yep.
So little Buster, he's 7 years, 2 months and 4 weeks old. A mini foxy mixed breed with chihuahua. I think he's got papillon in him. Look at those ears. Did you know what papillon means?
No.
It's French for butterfly.
There you go.
And that's why they have those ears.
Aww. Because
they look like
that's
a butterfly.
Quite fitting.
And little Miss Zozo. What is that? It's definitely only a face the mother could love. Zoe's 8. She's a de-sexed female mini foxy mixed breed with chihuahua hua hua hua.
These guys are super bonded. We took Zoe out this morning without Buster, and the whole time she was looking for him, she was crying, she was pulling on the lead, and as soon as he came, fine.
Yeah, so you can get an increase of things like separation anxiety.
Absolutely.
All the rest, if you separate them, you can see lots of undesirable behaviours as well.
Yeah.
They have to go together.
We've got a lovely pair of dogs who are bonded, so I think we try them too.
If they're open to the idea, that would be so good.
How cute's the hamster?
He feels really coarse, hey?
Mm. He's not a smooth guinea pig.
Like a bit like my hair.
We're back.
Spirit fingers, everybody.
Spirit fingers.
So we found a couple of options. We have a little boy. His name is Buster, and he is 7 years old. He's a little papillon cross, so he's got the ears.
Right, yes.
And you'll be pleased to know that Buster does do excited little wheeze.
Yes.
Quite often.
Second option. We also have Zoe, who is 8. She is a Chihuahua Maltese cross, I believe, or Chihuahua Shih Tzu cross.
Character-filled.
Totally character-filled. She's just the cutest little lady. Catch is, though...
they have to come together. They are a bonded pair.
So when you separate him, he looks for her the whole time.
Oh,
so they are absolutely in love.
God. I was expecting to meet one dog. Not two. They were very clever because they said, yeah, they have to go together.
Honey, you look a little bit more skeptical.
I'm fine. I'm open to all possibilities. Yeah. I love that they're in love. This is like the best love
story
ever.
They are so in love.
And as a married celebrant, I love love. So I could marry them. Like, perfect. We could have
doggy weddings.
Doggy wedding. We could have a dog ceremony.
Can you imagine her in a little tutu and a veil?
It's a love story. It's a love story. It's happening.
Would you to meet them?
I'll be happy to meet them.
Okay,
both,
great.
As Taylor Swift once says, it's a love story, baby, just say yes. Where am I?
On that note, let's organise a meet.
Let's go, guys.
Let's go, girls. Oh my God, they're so in love.
Oh my God.
Oh, let's just see.
Buster
just
and see. Zoe.
Newlyweds Craig and Rodney are nervously waiting to meet another happy couple, Zoe and Buster.
Just Buster move.
Oh, I love them.
I think I need to do a nervous wee. I'm just excited thinking about what life will be like with a new dog or dogs and...
types of things that we'll do as a family. I just literally can't wait.
He's so excited though, he can't even sit still.
Waited so long for this moment.
What if you like one and not the other?
You can't separate them, they're in love.
It's just gotta be right.
Open your mind.
Who do you think's gonna make the final decision?
I think Rodney's a sweetheart and I think he just wants to make him happy.
Yeah. The point where I thought that I could lose Craig, it was a dark place to be thinking along those lines.
I never expected that at 38 I would have a heart attack. And I remember Rodney, when I rang him and said, I'm in the midst of a heart attack, you need to get me to a hospital. And I've just never heard silence on a phone. And I'm like, hello?
When we returned home from hospital, I didn't want him to go to sleep and for me to wake up and he's gone. Like, that's horrible to think that. So it was very, the times, they were a bit scary. They were a bit scary. And they were scary after he had the pacemaker.
Zoe and Buster were medical surrenders.
Buster, you gotta wait for your sister.
They've been given a clean bill of health by our vets and are now ready to find their new forever home.
I can hear them. Oh my god, what are the little
sweeties?
I can see it under the door. Oh my god, stop.
What's that?
Hello.
Hi. How are you guys?
Good, how are you?
Good, thank you.
Oh my god.
Alright, we have Miss Zoe here. She's probably going to come up first.
Hello,
and
Zoe.
Buster, who wants to just smell the water. There we go. There's Buster.
Hello, Buster.
Are you guys comfortable for me to unclip them?
Yeah, yes. Go for it.
All right, Zoe first, meeting here. So, just probably let them have a smell around. Yep. They obviously can't probably get up to that height. So if you want to sit on the lower step or on the floor, go for it. I'll also might get you some treats for them.
Okay, awesome. Bit of water in there, mate.
Did you fall in the pond?
Zoe, Buster. Hi, boy. Hi. Hi, Bubba. Hi.
I think Craig is definitely more sold on two dogs than I am.
Hi.
He's super keen, Jelly Bean.
Do you want to come home to my place? Kisses.
For me, I'll just have to take gradual steps.
Hi, beautiful Gil. Hi, darling. Hey.
Just don't think Rodney looks that impressed.
Oh, that's it.
Perhaps Rodney's not sure about having two of them.
Yeah. Hard enough in itself to rehome one dog, let alone two. It's double the cost in feed, double the cost in medical bills, double the care, double the time, double the patience, so it's really tricky.
Scratch, 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 scratch. There's a play date. There's a play date.
After losing her canine companion of 16 years, Rose is ready for a new relationship.
I'm just looking forward to having somebody to share the world with. Somebody who gets as excited about the world as I do.
Hi.
Hello.
And who gives me an excuse to be a bit nutty.
Have you been looking for a new companion for a while?
No, I lost my last dog in October last year.
I'm so sorry. Yeah, so... I'm so sorry to hear.
Yeah, so I'm really missing him and... just need a new little one in my life.
I think we can learn a lot from the dogs, as they did teach you about unconditional love.
Oh, it's a dress. How cute.
About forgiveness. And just to be friends with everybody.
Hello.
Hello. Hi, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm well.
The dog? Oh, they're the best, hey?
I'm not worried if it's a dog that's got any sort of issues.
Yeah, a dog that has a little bit of anxiety you're open to as well.
So, with Dave, he was very super shy.
Was that your last dog, Dave? Yeah. Okay, do you want to tell us a bit about him?
He was full of personality. When he passed, I got over 400 messages.
Wow.
People.
Pretty famous.
Yeah. To be in his company was the greatest pleasure for me. He was my rock and I really hate going home now and he's not there. I find that such a huge challenge to walk into that apartment. I miss being Dave's mum. Because he was so, because he just gave so much.
Do you live with anyone else?
No, I don't. We do live in a community that's very dog-loving. and I actually also run a small dog meetup group called Pup Dates.
Oh, cute.
So, yes, this dog will be surrounded by people.
Okay.
Yeah. I did want to have children, but it just didn't happen. And so my world got set up around dogs. And so now not to have a dog, like, it's really funny. I go to the meetup groups and now I'm the only one that doesn't have a dog. You know, that's just weird.
Well, I've got a few ideas in mind that we're going to go excellent. Have a chat for you. Thank you. We'll be back.
It's a lovely dress.
What was that?
It's a lovely dress.
They're probably trying to find a small spotty dog for me now.
So lovely. So kind.
Pat me, pat me, pat me. Hello, Bubby. Buster and Zoe are literally Rodney and I in dog form. I would be Buster and Zoe would be Rodney.
Thanks.
Because Rodney has an overbite.
Offensive. Come on, belly rub.
Yeah. What are your thoughts? Serious thoughts.
They are, like, they're active.
But are they too active?
How can you say no to those faces? Look at them. Zoe.
It's hard to tell what Rodney's thinking, though.
Yeah. I feel like his eyes are smitten. He's got love heart eyes for sure.
I think that'd be perfect. The challenge around having two dogs is definitely cost, I think, because the expenditure just doubles. Your food doubles, grooming doubles, all that doubles.
And they're a package deal, I guess, so. Buster, come on, mate. Zoe, come on. They can do their own thing. They come when they're called. They both fight for your attention.
In time.
I love everything with my job.
Sorry, mate.
You're very cute. Helping the animals out is a major passion. But obviously, we get animals who come in who do need a bit of help and rehabilitation. It drives my passion more, especially when they've come in and been abused and neglected.
Go, go, go!
Charity worker Rose is hoping the matchmakers have found her a companion to share her life with.
What about Lulu?
Her vibrant attitude and just how crazy she can be and social is going to be suited for Rose.
She did mention too she was okay with a dog that's a little bit quieter, and she did say she's happy to work with it.
Yeah.
Oh, so she knows how to do that then, so she's...
Yeah, she definitely seems quite experienced, which is really good.
Okay, well, discussing that, let's, what about Romeo?
1 year old and 3 months, D-sex male. The only thing I would be concerned about is it does say here, no dogs and no children, but I just think that's to do with his anxiety. I think with time, he will come out of his shell.
With that though, she's probably the best fit for someone like Romeo.
Yeah.
She has the best patience, she has time, she has experience.
No kids.
She's already, no kids, and she's... By the sounds, already done that before a lot of dogs.
Yeah, that's
so
true.
So for Romeo needs that extra special person where, you know, we're going to have some time
gonna
and patience
time
in
with
it.
Him, yeah.
All right, Rose, got a good option for you.
Yeah.
His name is Romeo, 2 years old.
Yeah.
Super sweet boy. Once he warms up to you, you can't get rid of him. Yeah. He's a Shih Tzu cross.
Oh, my God. He sounds really sweet and really gorgeous too. Sweet boy.
We definitely think you're the perfect person that's going to suit him because your personality is going to bring him out to his
excellent.
Best.
Because it sounds like somebody that needs a little bit of love.
Would you like to meet?
I'd love to meet Romeo.
Okay, let's go meet Romeo.
There's your toy.
Oh. Romeo can be quite nervous around other dogs, especially if they are a little bit bigger than him.
You're so cute.
Yeah. Romeo came into our care about 8 weeks ago because the owner just didn't really have time for him anymore. So he needs someone that's going to be understanding of that but willing to give him that time and patience to flourish into that beautiful little smoochy boy we know he can be.
Let's go, Munchkin.
Good boy. I don't do well being dogless. I absolutely hate going home and he's save. Every dog is special and every dog has its own personality.
Oh, Remy, where are you?
So that's what I'm looking forward to, is finding out who's there under that fur coat.
Hello.
You're beautiful.
How could somebody not fall in love with you?
So, this is little Romeo.
Hello. Am I allowed to pick Mr. Romeo up?
So I wouldn't be picking him up straight away. Okay. So he can be a bit funny, you know, with touch at first.
He is so beautiful.
He is really sweet. Are you happy if I let him off lead?
Oh, please do.
Yeah, awesome.
He needs to run. He needs to be full Romeo.
Come on, Mr. Romeo, come on. You're already going to come with me, eh?
Come on.
Oh, that's a really good reaction from Romeo.
Oh, it's a bit crazy, dog. And I probably like naughty dogs better than well-behaved dogs. I'm quite naughty as well. So I think we sort of have that in common.
You are too much fun.
You're never going to let me catch you, are you? No. Nope.
Rose is loving it.
Oh, how
cute. Oh. Well, he looks quite happy. I might leave you to be. Joy. Crazy
nuts.
Boy.
I said I wanted a dog that was nuts.
I'm trying to initiate a bit of play with Rose, which is nice to see. That's
great. So cute.
Gotta stay.
Come on, little sweetie. Come on. Come here. Come on.
He's looking back at Rose going, hey, what's
hang
happening?
On a minute.
Hopefully he does come over to Rose.
Hey, Romeo.
When Taylor was in there, he seemed a lot more comfortable. He hasn't gone to Rose too much, which hopefully, given a bit of time, he does come over.
Romeo! Romeo!
Come on, Romeo.
Hey, sweetheart. Hey, Mr. Romeo. Romeo! Romeo! I was so concerned whether Romeo will like me and accept me.
Hey, sweetheart. Hey, Mr. Romeo.
What do you make out of all of this? It's all a pretty big world, isn't it?
There we go.
That's good. He's gone up to Rose and taken it as well. Although he spat it out, he wanted to take it.
Is that okay? I'm not going to hurt you. It's all like, would you like to come and live with me? You've got to make a decision here, Bubba.
She sounds a bit more sure now.
Yeah.
I think she just needed to cuddle it a little bit.
Yeah, of course.
That's where the switch is, hey? Whoa. You're a Zoomy champion.
So nice to see her being this happy after losing such a close companion to life.
And I could just do this all day, just give you cuddles. Oh, somebody's back.
How did we go? Did we make friends?
Oh, he is spectacular. He's complete nuts.
Did you want to perhaps take him for a walk?
I'd love to take him for a walk. Dogs definitely allow me to be my best self. They're very much like children. Children can't do things for themselves. You've got to do them. You've got to step up to the mark.
Look at you go. You little speedster.
So I was looking forward to having somebody to share the world with. I miss just having a dog. But life has changed completely since I've got Romeo.
You've got it all sorted these days. You do, hey, Mr. Romeo?
Oh, it's great having a dog to take to the doggy meetups again.
So cute.
I am in love with a little bloke. He is just absolutely and utterly incredible. And I could not be more sure that bringing him home was the best decision I have ever made in my entire life.
Tessa, it was a nice experience. She was a little bit timid.
We did have a
whether or not we were the right family for Tessa. We were worried being a rescue dog, what it would be like with Finn. But we've decided to keep her. Tessa! Tessa, come! Come, girl! Hi!
Hey! I don't think Tessa's good or super special. I think she's better than every special word you could say in the world. I like her a golden retriever sort of ease.
She's gone from being this very timid, shy dog to just being a very loving, caring...
Wants to be up in the skin kind of dog.
Yeah, she just wants to be happy
she
and
just wants
loved.
To be loved.
I loved meeting Zoe and Buster. They were full of life, full of energy, but I was very unsure about taking two dogs.
Also, when we met Zoe and Buster, it looked like they had some kind of denture problem, so we really had to see how much that's going to cost us into the future. There was a lot to consider. In the end, we absolutely could not say no to Zoe and Buster. We loved them too much.
Zoe and Buster!
Come on, come on, come on! Hi, hi, hi! Hello, hi! Hi, Mommy! Yay! Now I feel like we've got our own growing family.
Mental children.
It's changed my life. I was never going walking, and I'm finding each day that we can go a little bit further. So it's allowed me to kind of rebuild my own fitness.
He's tired. He's tired today, Buster.
Zoe and Buster absolutely love each other. They follow each other everywhere, lick each other's faces. When they go to bed, they snuggle into each other. I love them so much.
Yeah, I love them a lot.
Like a little baby.
24 hours and
that was it. I was done.
So, where am I going?
Mark. Do, 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 do.
Next time on The Doghouse.
I was bit by my cousin's dog.
Will this porcelain pooch become a young girl's fear?
When I see a dog, usually I freeze.
Spaniel Sophie wants a friend to stop her family fighting for her attention.
Fight over her at bedtime and, yeah, causes them to stress.
And...
good girl.
Will it be Schnitzel?
Isn't this happy on her wedding
night? I just love her.
She's so gorgeous.
Or Lily. Who'll win this couple's heart?
Oh, you're gonna fall off.